Prabhat Ranjan Sarkar. Prabhat Ranjan Sarkar, also known by his spiritual name, Shrii Shrii Ánandamúrti, and known as Bábá to his disciples, was a spiritual guru, Indian philosopher, yogi, author, social revolutionary, poet, composer, and linguist. Sarkar was the founder of Ananda Marga in 1955, a spiritual and social organization that offers instruction in meditation and yoga. Gyani Zail Singh, 7th President of India, has said about Sarkar, "Prabhat Ranjan Sarkar was one of the greatest modern philosophers of India. Sarkar's system of spiritual practice has been described as a practical synthesis of Vedic and Tantric philosophies. He denounced materialism and capitalism, and described the universe as a result of macropsychic conation. The entire universe exists within the cosmic mind, which itself is the first expression of consciousness coming under the bondage of its own nature." Sarkar was a prolific author and produced an extensive body of works that includes theories aimed at increasing human welfare, such as the law of social cycle, the progressive utilization theory, the theory of microvitam, as well as the philosophy of neo-humanism. Sarkar was born during the full moon of the Indian month of Vaishakh, on May 11, 1922, to Lakshmi Narayan Sarkar, a homeopathic doctor of considerable renown. His family hailed from Bamunpura, Burdwan district in West Bengal. Sarkar was known as an exceptionally bright child in his youth, practicing meditation by himself at an early age and displaying great knowledge of various languages and various topics, knowledge which was reportedly not gained in school, by reading books, nor by listening to teachers, nor from any other outer source. In 1939, Sarkar left Jamalpur for Kolkata to attend Vidyasagar College of the University of Calcutta. Sarkar had to quit his studies to support his family after the death of his father, and from 1944 until the early 1950s, Sarkar worked as an accountant at the Indian Railways headquarters in Jamalpur, Bihar. He taught the techniques of ancient tantra meditation to a select number of his colleagues, and gradually more and more people were drawn to the spiritual practices he taught. In 1955, Sarkar founded Ananda Marga, a socio-spiritual movement with a two-part mission that Sarkar stated as self-realization and service to all. His system of spiritual practice has been described as a practical synthesis of Vedic and Tantric philosophies. Sarkar's ideas are collected in the series of books called Subhasita Samgraha, which form part of the philosophical scriptures of Ananda Marga ideology. Sarkar's ideas are steeped in the ancient spiritual tradition of humanity, considerably developed in India, yet revitalized by him with new meaning and universal approach. During the latter part of his life, his main residence was in Lake Gardens in Kolkata, West Bengal. He also spent much time, especially early on, in the all-round development community he founded based on his Prout theory at Anandanagar. Ananda Marga opened regional offices in various countries, including the USA in 1969, and by 1973 had established approximately 100 local centers teaching yogic and social philosophies, with several thousand members, some living communally in the ashrams. In 1971, Sarkar was imprisoned in India for the alleged murder of Ananda Marga members. In February 1973, Sarkar was poisoned in prison, allegedly by the jail doctor on orders from the higher echelons of government. On April 1st, after recovering his health, Sarkar began fasting in support of a demand for an inquest into his poisoning. That demand was never met. So he continued his fast for the next 5 years, 4 months, and 2 days, until August 2, 1978, when he was released from jail after having been acquitted of all charges. In 1979, Sarkar took 2 world tours to meet disciples in various countries around the world, including Switzerland, Germany, France, Scandinavia, the Middle East, Philippines, Thailand, Taiwan, Jamaica, and Venezuela. He was barred from entering the USA by the State Department, so instead he met his American disciples in Jamaica in 1979. Just before he died on October 21, 1990, he founded Ananda Marga Gurukula on September 7, 1990. An educational network to preserve and develop his legacy through research, teaching, and service. Thomas Lombardo on Sarkar's philosophy. Sarkar's teachings on spiritual philosophy are based on a rational and universalistic approach that has been described as an innovative and practical synthesis of Vedic and Tantric philosophies. He considered himself to be an incorrigible optimist in his thinking. Sarkar describes the universe as a result of macropsychic conation. The entire universe exists within the cosmic mind, which itself is the first expression of consciousness coming under the bondage of its own nature. With the evolution of unit beings, individual life, the extraversial projection of the cosmic mind starts the return journey in an always unique and colorful fashion. No two entities of this universe are the same, and yet all have the same goal to merge once more with their source, the infinite cosmic consciousness. As such, the cosmological flow is from limitless consciousness to limited consciousness and back to limitless consciousness, attained by meditation. According to Sarkar's philosophy, the individual mind is composed of five layers called koshas. Sarkar's biopsychology explains how the traditional tantric science of chakras with their subtle energies are related with the body through nerve plexi as physiologic counterparts, influencing the associated endocrine glands with the neuroendocrine system and the psychic part of the body. The philosophy of Ananda Marga consider the human body as composed of the same five fundamental factors as the rest of the universe as explained in P.R. Sarkar's theory of Brahmachakra. Every factor is distributed throughout the body, but is controlled by a controlling nucleus, or chakra, substations of the mind, each controlling their own assigned area. And just as the mind functions directly through the brain, the chakras function through their own physical counterparts, the endocrine glands. The biopsychology of Ananda Marga expands with further explanations the concept of the seven basic chakras and in general, mainly considers. Microvita is plural for microvitam and literally means possessing or with micro-life. The microvita theory was first introduced by Sarkar on 1986 through a series of lectures. According to this intuitional theory, microvita are entities which come within the realms both of physicality and psychic expression. They are smaller and subtler than physical atoms and subatomic particles, and in the psychic realm they may be subtler than mind stuff, and contribute to a pure consciousness. Sarkar predicted that they will soon be recognized by conventional science. In Sarkar's microvita theory, microvita seems to be the first expressions of life. However, this concept, still in its infancy, conceives of various types of microvita, both positive and negative, at varying degrees of evolutionary existence. A central point in Sarkar's philosophy is the concept of sadhana. He describes sadhana as a practice for the transformation of fearful love into fearless love. Sadhana is concretized in particular with the practice of meditation for complete merger and unification. Sarkar recommends to his disciples the daily practice of individual meditation and the weekly practice of collective meditation. These meetings called Dharmachakras are preceded by the collective singing of a few Prabhat Samjita, followed by Bába Nam Kevalam Kirtan, then the mantra called Samgakadvam. The mantra Nityam Shuddham marks the end of the collective meditation, then the spiritual gathering will end with the Guru Puja mantra. The concept of Varna describes four main socio-psychological types, whereby human psychological and physical endowment and social motivations are expressed: the Vipra, Kshatriya, Vaishya, and Shudra. Varna, in Sarkar's perspective, however, is more than just a psychological trait but rather an archetype, approximately to Michel Foucault's notion of epistemes, which are broader frameworks of knowledge defining what is true and real. Sarkar's law of social cycle applies these traits in a theory of historical evolution, where ages rise and fall in terms of ruling elites representing one of the above-mentioned traits. This law possibly connects to the earlier cyclical historical ideas of Sri Aurobindo, with a focus on the psychology of human development, as well as Ibn Khaldun, among other macro historians' ideas about cycles. However, along with a cyclical dimension, the rise and fall of ages, Sarkar's theory exhibits a correspondent linear dimension, in that economic and technological progress are considered critical in terms of meeting the changing material conditions of life. Ultimately, for Sarkar, true progress has to prioritize development in the spiritual dimension. Spirituality for Sarkar is defined as the individual realizing the true self. In addition to yogic meditational practices and purity of thought and deed, Sarkar attached great importance to selfless social service as a means of liberation. Sarkar considered it necessary for the social arrangements to support the inner development of human beings and rejected both capitalism and communism as appropriate social structures for humanity to move forward to the golden age of a balanced way of life sustaining all-round progress. A serious problem with capitalism was, according to Sarkar, the concentration of wealth in a few hands and stoppages in the rolling of money, which he considered root causes of recessions, even depressions. A spiritual way of life, however, would in no way be divorced from creating structures that help meet the basic, though ever-changing, needs: food, housing, clothing, health, and education. Sarkar claims to have developed both Ananda Marga and the progressive utilization theory as practical means to encourage harmony and cooperation to help society escape this proposed cycle. Sarkar argues that once the social cycle is understood and sadvapras evolved, then the periods of exploitation can be largely reduced, if not eliminated. With leadership that is representative of all aspects of the varnas, that is, the leader engaged in service, who is courageous, who uses the intellect for the benefits of others, and who has innovative/entrepreneurial skills, the cycle can become an upward spiral. Sarkar's concept of karma samnyasa refers to the principle that a yogi becomes a person with all-round development and a balanced mind, that he called a sadvapra, and that this is accomplished by someone who remains fixed on the supreme consciousness through transformative personal practices and engaging in the politics of social liberation as a form of service work. By 1959, Sarkar had developed the socio-economic progressive utilization theory. In 1961, the theory was formally outlined in his book Ananda Sutram, published under his spiritual name Shrii Shrii Ánandamúrti. In 1968, Sarkar founded the organization Proudest Bloc of India, to further the ideals of his theory through political and social action. The PBI was soon superseded by Proudest Universal, which primarily consists of 5 federations. A proud economy is cooperative and decentralized. Its focus is collective welfare rather than to profit, without neglecting individuals and their merits. Progressive utilization refers to the optimizing the use of natural, industrial, and human resources on a sustainable basis for the entire ecosystem. The theory claims to overcome the limitations of both capitalism and communism. It is in line with Sarkar's social theory of the law of social cycle. The theory aims to encompasses the whole of individual and collective existence for all beings, including physical, educational, social, political, mental, cultural and spiritual. In 1982, Sarkar extended his writings on the subject of human society with the introduction of his new theory of neo-humanism. If humanism tends to contemplate only humans in a human-centric view, neo-humanism, according to Sarkar's theory, is instead the elevation of humanism to universalism. Sarkar said, when the underlying spirit of humanism is extended to everything, animate and inanimate, in this universe I have designated this as neo-humanism. This neo-humanism will elevate humanism to universalism, the cult of love for all created beings of this universe. Neo-humanism is said to prefer to existential value over utility value for all living beings. Sarkar's neo-humanism places great emphasis on rationality and encourages what he calls a proto-spiritual mentality, a process of continually recognizing each object with which we come in contact, externally or internally, as a manifestation of the supreme consciousness. According to Sarkar, rationality helps to give rise to devotion, which he considered to be the highest and most valuable treasure of humanity. In Sarkar's view, neo-humanism leads to the liberation of human intellect from the constraints of imposed dogma and psychic complexes, helping to bridge the gap between the inner and outer worlds. In his series of discourses Talks on Prout, given in Ranchi in July 1961, Sarkar makes a distinction between the terms culture and customs. According to Sarkar, culture is the collective name for different expressions of life. But all of society has the same culture. There are local variations in the mode or state of cultural expression, but the expression is universal. These local variations are called customs. Thus, local modes of expression bearing local or group specialties are customs, but the expression itself is culture. Therefore, it is a mistake to readjust boundaries on the basis of language and culture. Indian culture and the culture of the world are one and the same. The philosophy of Sarkar reinterprets the general concept of culture by inserting it into a new universalistic outlook. As described by Antonello Maggi Pinto, if the term culture is usually referred to the original meaning of this word, then Sarkar offers a new point of view, with a large universalistic explanation. The culture of the whole human race is one, but marked by different local manifestations. It is the same, but varying in expression. The vast linguistic work of Sarkar has been published in several volumes, including Varna Vijnana, Sarkar's English Grammar and Composition, Varna Visitra, and the Encyclopedic Shavda Kayanika in Bengali. In Varna Vijnana, he presents the eight criteria which define a language. In his book Talks on Prout, Sarkar considers languages as a part of natural diversity and calls for the adoption of a global language and script, to enable better global communication and understanding. We should love all these languages, hate none, and adopt one of these languages as the world language. As all languages are our common property, we should not oppose the existence of other languages. We should not brand any language as foreign or national. The Ananda Marga organization uses a transliteration style which differs from the international alphabet of Sanskrit transliteration, as herein charted. Thus, according to Sarkar, education is for liberation. He defines education as the simultaneous development in the physical, mental, and spiritual realms of human existence, by which dormant human potentialities would be awakened and put to proper use. Sarkar firmly believed that real education leads to a pervasive sense of love and compassion for all creation. In Ananda Marga education system, special emphasis is given to moral education and the inculcation of idealism, together with a proper psychopedagogical approach and a happy blending of Occidental extroversial science and Oriental introversial philosophy. He founded Ananda Marga Gurukula with its headquarters at Anandanagar just 44 days prior to his physical departure, and gave it the mandate to serve humanity with neo-humanist spirit and acquire knowledge for that purpose. He also introduced the faculty of neo-humanist education in Gurukula. Although Sarkar spent only 17 years of his life working full-time for his organizations, he left behind a vast legacy, including over 250 books written on a wide variety of topics. Many of these books are compilations or collections of speeches given by him during spiritual or social meetings. He is primarily known as the spiritual teacher behind Ananda Marga, but Sarkar wrote over 1,500 pages on his socio-politico-economic progressive utilization theory, with several thousand more pages dedicated to linguistics and the study of languages. Sarkar's writings on linguistics included, among other works, Shavda Kayanika, an unfinished, 26-volume dictated encyclopedia on the Bengali language. Beyond this, he wrote books on sociology, agriculture, history, literature, education, medicine, cosmology, and philosophy, also notably founding the philosophy of neo-humanism in 1982 and the theory of Microvita in 1986. In his theory of Microvita, Sarkar believed that the atoms and the subatomic particles throughout the boundless universe are imbued with life. In 1982, Sarkar started composing songs. In 8 years, until the date of his death, he completed the composition of 5,018 songs in multiple languages. This vast collection of songs is called Prabhat Samjyaita.